Hello, everybody. How's it going? Happy Monday. I am super excited to have a very important guest today. Very important guest because without guests such as Chris here, our houses in California would hollow out from the inside and fall onto our heads without us ever knowing it. So, welcome, Chris.
Well, thank you for having me, Roxanne. That was a gracious opening and an introduction about what termites might do to our homes and the homes that you sell as a real estate agent.
Exactly. So I would say you are one of those people that are holding the real estate transaction on your arms just like that, making sure that the transaction goes through smoothly. Would I say that that's the case? Would you say that's the case?
Well, I think that that accolade might go to the agents. We are certainly one of the cogs in the wheel of the real estate transaction. I do agree with your assessment. It's a very important one. One of the most expensive expenses that a seller or person, perhaps even a buyer, might have is the termite control in the transaction. There's a lot of issues that can be hidden there. And for over 35 years, I have been helping to find those problems prior to someone selling or a buyer buying. Very helpful for them.
Excellent, excellent. Wow. Over 35 years in the business.
That's correct. 25 is the owner of Nick's Termite Professional Pest Solutions.
Very nice, very nice. Okay, so tell us a little bit about your business.
I'd love to. My family has a background in engineering and chemicals. My parents own a chemical plant as I was growing up, so I was never very squeamish about working around chemicals and their products and the needs to utilize them. So when I first got out of college and for business and marketing, I went in to work for Terminix. A few of your listeners might have heard of that company. And during that period of time, I learned about the real estate industry and its relationship with termite control and what the agents did and what they needed from a company like Nick's Termite. And so 25 years ago, I decided to create Nick's Termite, which was especially designed to meet a real estate agent's needs. The needs being they needed usually a certification which has evidence of termites in the industry. They may call that Section 1 items, which is termites, termite damage, fungus, and the conditions that are conducive to those in someone's home or business. And then there's also other items which are called Section 2 that have not created any damage. There's no termites, but like plumbing leaks and earth to wood contacts and things of that nature. So when we brought this company about, we realized that many of the termite companies in the industry did not really provide. They provided treatment, but not the repairs and the solutions that agents needed, a one-stop shop, if you will. So I also acquired a general contractor's license and the ability to make sure that when an agent needed a home closed fast, that we were able to bring in to bear not only the treatment, but the repairs necessary to make sure that a home was sound. One of our slogans is helping to make San Diego homes healthier.
Oh, nice. Very cool. Well, that literally is true, isn't it?
It is. We find that a lot of our competitors will provide estimates that say that there is damage and that it needs to be corrected, but there's no avenue for the agent or homeowner to figure out how to correct those issues, which can cause delays in the transaction process, especially right now for the VA lender, which the VA does require these certifications. Having a knowledgeable company that can return the home to its original wood frame and industry standards is important. If a company is not qualified, or if they overlook it to provide a lower price just to facilitate the loan, the buyer and or seller could have some liability there. And we see that quite often.
Right, right, exactly. So I wanted to share with the audience your website. So if you can tell us more about what your services are, and go a little bit into what you provide. I see that you're doing more than just termites. You're also offering other pests control services.
Yeah, a little bit of background. The real estate industry is not just looking for a termite inspection. They're looking for a WDO inspection, which is a wood destroying organisms. In California, there's basically three licenses, one for wood destroying organisms, which include termites, termite damage, and fungus damage. There's also general pest, which are your ants and rodents and fleas and things of that nature. Our company holds both licenses. And then there's also a trapping license for skunks and critters like that. We do not hold that license and have not found the need to do so. And occasionally some of the pest control companies will acquire an agricultural license for spraying of bushes and things for agricultural type pests. While our company is licensed by the state of California, and most pest control companies are, if they have a structural pest control license to do repairs, it doesn't mean they're qualified. And we found quite quickly that in order to make sure or ensure that the liability to the agents and the satisfaction of the customers, getting a contractor's license and ensuring that the carpentry we do was done thoroughly would be included. So on our website, we talk about pest control, termites, how we work with real estate agents, and really virtually our story about how we came to be and how we expanded to be the company that we are today. We are on par with the companies like Lloyd's, or one of the other local area companies, although a good portion of our business is primarily directed at real estate agents and their transactions. We work for a lot of banks, lenders, especially for the refis going on right now.
Right, right. So when do you see a lot of termite repairs or clearances needed when customers are trying to do refis as well?
Refis, they're being asked for, especially for the VA, but not so much for the FHA or the standard loans out there. Many of the homes, because of the cost of the homes nowadays, even though they're not required per se, the seller is often providing one because the buyer is paying top dollar. And the buyer is often requesting that information so that they have a knowledge about what's going on in their house. A home, when people are selling their homes, they often paint them, clean them up, make them look ready to sell. But what we find quite often is that the homeowners have covered the damage, not to try to hide, but just to spruce up the home. And quite often that damage can be anywhere from a couple of thousand to $10,000, $20,000, $30,000 worth of damage when it's not looked at or found. And later that can cause conflict and legal issues with not only the seller, but the agent as well.
So I see that that you are offering a warranty. How does the warranty work? And when there's a purchase, how does that you know, how does that warranty work?
That's a great question. We found that the Structural Pest Control Board of California recommends annual inspections. And so we have a plan we call the Healthy Homes Protection Plan. And so after we a customer has us inspect their home, we put them on our Healthy Homes Protection Plan, as you have on the website right there. Thank you. That allows the customer to call us for free every year for as long as they own the home, and it's transferable. Okay, so we will come back every year for free and perform an inspection on the home to give them updates about what's going on. There's no obligation. We just provide the free inspection. Now, if they purchase a fumigation or a whole house treatment that we offer, then they not only get the HHPP, but they also get a treatment warranty. The treatment warranty is anywhere from a year to 5 years initially, and that they can renew on an annual basis as soon as it expires. This allows us not only to come in and let them know what's going on in the way of termites and perhaps damage, but if there's any treatment to be done and they're covered, it's done at no charge, including and up to a fumigation if that were necessary. This lets them know that a 20-year plus professional, all of our inspectors have a lot of history and professionalism. They will come in and share what they find without obligation on the home. And if the item that we find is covered, then it's treated or repaired for free.
Excellent. Excellent. So I see that you are basically all over the county of San Diego. So tell us about your coverage in all the areas that you service.
Well, that's right. Thank you for bringing that up, Roxanne. We cover all of San Diego County for real estate agents, homeowners, businesses, HOA properties to perform inspections, treatments, repairs, and for the pest control, we do have a little bit smaller or limited area. Right now, we're limited to the south or the southern portion of San Diego County, about Highway 52 and south, from the ocean at La Jolla all the way east to Alpine.
Got it. And I love that you have your customer reviews on the section, but they're also scrolling down at the bottom. So tell us some stories that are fun to share with our audience.
Well, we've been rated by Nextdoor, which is a relatively new app, as one of the Nextdoor favorites. That's in a community of wherever you live or wherever your business is. The Nextdoor neighborhood, if they utilize you and they see you on there, they just put a little heart and they say to everybody else that they love you. So we are rated as a favorite the first year out with Nextdoor. On Yelp, we have over 300, mostly five-star reviews. With Google, we have over 100 five-star reviews. And that, as you probably know, or any other business owner or agent that's listening, it's not very easy to do. You know, not everybody leaves a review for what you do, and you do your best. You try to provide the best service, and we do a guarantee that no customer will be unsatisfied with the work that we do. Like any company, errors can be made, and when they're pointed out, we make sure that every customer is completely satisfied. We know, especially in the real estate industry, integrity and the agent wanting to work with these clients again, they don't want to refer somebody that is going to make them look bad. So we try to ensure that the customers are always satisfied. And that's pretty easy to do. I mean, when you see termites and it's gone, they don't come back right away. And when there's damage that's being repaired, really virtually anybody can see that the damage is gone and it's been painted and it looks like the home did before the damage occurred. So our goal is to ensure that every customer is fully satisfied.
So, Chris, tell us about tent fumigation.
Tent fumigations? A lot of people think tent fumigations are fairly archaic, but the fact of the matter is, if there was a better method that could be utilized to eradicate drywood termites, which is what they're primarily for, it would be utilized. The state of California has determined that a tent fumigation utilizing Vicaine gas is about 99.9% effective for drywood termites. Hence, you still see the tents. One of the special things that we do with our tent fumigations is we provide a theft deterrent. Now, there's not any other company that's doing that right now unless there's some large expense. But because of some thefts due to the economy or whatever reason, it's a target because thieves know that nobody is there. We have provided a theft deterrent for all of our customers for every job that we do. We've only had one attempted break-in, and it's been quite successful. It puts alarms in the windows, extra locks, finger locks on the windows, and a banner that lets criminals know that police will be called.
So you've had attempted break-ins when you have the tent over the house?
That's quite common knowledge that break-ins do occur. Criminals, knowing that there's nobody at the home, do occasionally try to break in. Now, it's not very frequent. We do anywhere between 600 to 800 fumigations a year, sometimes even more. And in that, we will usually have 5 or 6 break-ins during the course of the year. When we were using our theft deterrent, which we charge for or charged for in the past, we didn't have any. And so we made the decision this year that we would just include the theft deterrent in every fumigation that we do. And we worked it out with our fumigation team to ensure that that happened. Finger locks on the windows, motion sensors, and a banner that states that there is alarms and the police would be called. That's in conjunction with our own banner. The gas being used, that some people don't know, is a colorless, odorless gas, and it's non-residue, non-staining. As soon as the fumigation is over, there's no gas left in the house. There's nothing to be concerned about by the homeowner that is poisonous to the touch, smell, or anything. They can go right back in. The problem with that is, that's a good problem, but the associated problem with that is it doesn't keep termites out. And so when the termites swarm again, you will get them again. But that's why we decided to have a all-inclusive warranty that not only would treat for the first couple of years, but thereafter, the homeowner could either buy the treatment package again, but they would still be on our HHPP, our Healthy Homes Protection Plan, that allowed for the free inspections for the life of the home virtually. And if they were covered for the treatment, it would be done at no charge.
So I'm still flabbergasted that the thieves actually go through the challenge and break into a home that's under the tent. Aren't they scared that they're going to get poisoned? You know, if they're going through the tent to get inside the house?
One would think that it has a skull and crossbones on the paper on the outside of the tent that they would decide that it's not worth the effort. Not to mention that if the alarm goes off and they're caught, they could go to jail. But people sometimes do things that you or I wouldn't do. And our solution was to provide the theft deterrent to help the situation. When someone decides that's what they need, or if they're in a real estate transaction and they have no other choice because a company like ours or another one says, I'm not going to certify it unless it's tented, then there's an obligation factor. And so we just want the situation to be as eyes wide open as possible, educating the person to provide what they need on a fumigation. But because not all people want to do a fumigation or tent their home, we do offer a whole home healthy treatments, which include a variety of liquid products that, while they may not get to every spot in the home like a fumigation, they do have a far-reaching ability to not only treat the termites that are close to the surface, but the products can even transfer from living termites that don't die right away to other termites further in the home, completely eradicating colonies. Let me give you an example that's very important. There is a new termite in town. It's called a Formosan termite. Now, it's been around for a long time, but it's not very widespread in Southern California. As a matter of fact, some universities are doing research on it. It's come from the South Pacific, islands where they have a different biology, but they're able to do a lot of damage to a home in a short period of time. And a fumigation doesn't work. Oh, it's wow. A subterranean type termite. And so one would think, okay, we'll do a soil treatment. But even a soil treatment does not always completely eradicate the problem. The theory was if you treated soil, it kept the termites out of the house. And if they tried to pass that barrier, they would get it on them and they'd die. Well, for our standard subterranean termite, which is called a Western subterranean termite, that holds true. But the Formosan termite has the ability in their colony to build a colony above ground. So a treatment of the ground didn't keep them out, and the termites can really do serious damage on a home. And we've had to treat a home like that recently. It was misidentified by another company. And when we went out there, we took a sample, we took it to the agricultural department in San Diego. They confirmed that it was Formosan termite. And we worked with one of the local universities in California with entomologists to determine how we should proceed on that particular house. So if anything I could highlight about our company is with all the background and knowledge that we have and understanding about this particular field of endeavor, I think that customers can find some peace of mind that we can not only identify the problem, but we have a full treatment ability and repairability to take care of the solution, which should bring peace of mind to agents as well, knowing that their clients are taken care of. And we have a guarantee to meet or beat our competitors as long as it's for the same type of treatment and repair.
Got it. So when you are talking about subterranean termites, are you talking about homes that are on a raised foundation, or are you also talking about homes that are on a slab?
Fair question. Subterranean termites are in the soil. It doesn't matter what type of home that you have, whether it's on slab or it's on a raised foundation. Subterranean termites can gain access into a home that's on a slab foundation because there is expansion joints and occasionally cracks in that foundation. And there's areas where the plumbing goes through into the home, and that's where subterranean termites can gain access. For a raised foundation, subterranean termites can build mud tunnels up the foundation wall and into the wood frame of the home. So it's necessary to first identify that there are termites, what type of termites they are, and then the best treatment for that particular customer and the situation that they find themselves in.
Got it. My goodness. Now the world of termites, I had no idea that it could be so extensive, and we really cannot do without you guys. That's something that that I, as a real estate professional, always say, because a lot of people always say, well, you know, we can get our contractor to come and do this or do that, but they really need to be having a termite inspection done, because you guys are professionals. You're trained to find those pests and eradicate them along with just replacing wood.
Yeah, almost anybody can find them. It's deciding what to do about them and ensuring that it's done correctly with the right products and the right repair, the right material. We've seen just about it all, and quite often, if somebody's giving you a really cheap price and they don't, you know, I encourage your listeners that are real estate agents to look at the background of the company, not just the individual working for that company. The reputation of getting things done and satisfying their customers is paramount for us, but not always so much for some of our competitors. And when you're dealing with homes that are valued more than $500,000 and sometimes over $1 million, to have a quality termite company do the inspection, perform the work, can alleviate concerns about lawsuits and costly callbacks, your time, and we see that a lot.
Right. All right, very good. Well, thank you very much, Chris, for giving us your time and your knowledge to share with our audience today. And thank you, everybody, for watching. If you are trying to get a hold of Chris or somebody at his company, this is his name, Chris Aguilar. And you can either reach the company by calling this number, or you can call directly to their phone number, which is here. Their email address is at customer service. And if you are looking to go to their website, here is their website. And if you like our program, please give us a like. Please follow us on Instagram at Roxanne Govari. You can always reach me at my cell phone number right here, my email address. And if you like what you see, please give us a like and subscribe and tell your friends about our program. Thank you very much for joining us, Chris, and audience. Thank you so much for being here today.
Thanks for having me.